नमस्ते। टुडे वी हैव बोनफ्री मुर्गे दोस्त हु इज़ परसुइंग कंप्यूटर साइंस AI सेकेंड ईयर इन आवर बैंगलोर कैंपस। जस्ट टू ब्रीफ अबाउट हर अचीवमेंट्स, शी इज़ अ स्कॉलरशिप रेसिपिएंट इन द 2021 जनरेशन गूगल स्कॉलरशिप APSE एशिया स्पेसिफिक रीजन। वेलकम बोनफ्री। सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, लाइक can you please describe the influences that led you to engineering?
Okay, I think my journey to engineering started as early as when I was in, I think, first grade. I had my dad, we had a Windows XP computer at home, and I used to play around with the Paint app. And then slowly, my dad bought me games, and that's how my inquisitiveness towards what is really happening behind the scenes started arising. And thereon, after that, I think through my school, computer science was part of our syllabus. So I started enjoying the subject a lot. And I think throughout my school journey, that's when I decided that I would be pursuing computer science as my major.
Great, great to hear. How was the experience of transforming, like before joining Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham and after, like you've been 2 years in Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham?
I think it has been an amazing experience so far. I think the main reason being the teachers, the kind of dedication and the effort that they put in before each class. I think it just transcended onto us, and it was just obvious in a matter of few days that even we would be motivated with the kind of energy that they showed during the class. And my branch was pretty new, artificial intelligence, and we didn't have any seniors to guide us. So it was only our teachers who we were completely dependent upon. Even they were as new to the subjects as we were, but the kind of effort and the dedication that they showed, it was just wonderful. And it just motivated us to put in more effort and, you know, explore under their guidance.
Great. What are the awareness activities that led you to know about Google APSE?
So there's this club, it's called as the Google Developer Students Club, and it's a part of our campus, and the lead of the club is appointed by Google. So both when I was in my first year, the lead back then as well as now during my second year, they had like a wonderful communication network set up wherein they used to like let us know about opportunities, not just at Google, but also beyond Google. So I think that was my start. That was in my first year, I got to know about this scholarship. But back then, I didn't feel I had a good resume, or I had done enough outreach work to be able to sit through the scholarship process. So I worked on my skills over the next year. I started becoming more active in the clubs. I became a core team member at the Developer Students Club. And that's how I started. And I made sure that I worked on the right skills so that I would be a very good candidate for the scholarship. And that's how, those are the awareness activities that I came to know.
Interesting, interesting. How was the experience of attending and cracking this opportunity at Google? Google is always an excitement for students. So how was it for you?
It was wonderful. I think even just sitting through the entire process, I developed like so many skills that I didn't know that one could like develop just by preparing for an interview, preparing to sit for a selection process. So there were actually three rounds in my selection. So first was the resume shortlisting and my essay writing. They were mostly focused towards my outreach activities, my leadership roles that I had held, and mostly towards how we as me being a woman, I can help other women also explore roles in tech. So that was what the first round was. And after getting shortlisted, we had an online test to evaluate our academics as well. So we were tested on our aptitude, data structures and algorithm, computer science fundamentals. And it was called the Google Online Challenge. And after that, it was the Google interview. And during the interview as well, the focus was on my projects, my skills, my outreach efforts, the leadership roles. And those were the three rounds. And I think I did pretty well. And that's why I'm here.
No doubts on it. Definitely, like you said, the faculties of Amrita, of course, you require support and guidance. How influential were the teachers at Amrita to build a 21st century skills that help you to, you know, face this and crack this interview?
Yeah, it was definitely. I think the first step was resume shortlisting. And I was actually helping out a few of my friends prepare their resume, and they were coming, they didn't have much to put in their resume. But I think my course, at the end of each semester for each of the subjects we were working on projects, I actually didn't have enough space on my resume to mention all of my projects that I'd worked on. So that was how well, and these projects are not just like, we were working on technologies that are state of the art and are in that are being used extensively right now in the industry. And I feel even my course was structured in the same way. We were learning all the skills that were necessary to be an efficient software engineer, as well as a machine learning, deep learning specialist. So like, we started off our, I think the people who designed the course, they had a really good foresight as to how it would be helpful to us out there in the industry. And that's how it was structured as well. We had not only were we learning, say, if we take the example of machine learning, we weren't just learning what the algorithm is, but also learning how it works at the back end. We were learning the mathematics behind it. And if you take another example, like robotics. So we did, in our first year, we extensively studied kinematics and kinetics. We studied the mechanics before actually going on to program a robot. So I think it really helped us. Like, my skills definitely stood out because that's what was discussed during my interview as well. She was very interested in the projects that my interviewer was very interested in the project that I'd worked on. Yeah.
Super. Can you share some tips and key points that you will suggest for your, you know, fellow engineers to crack similar roles in a Google APC in the future?
The first step is awareness, because only if you're aware of the opportunity can you pursue it. So it's very essential that you keep looking at different websites, see what other students are doing, make connections on LinkedIn. LinkedIn has been very, very helpful for me. It was another medium through which I got to know what is the process, like how is the interview process at Google, and the experiences of other scholars, previous scholars. So make connections on LinkedIn and do not hesitate to talk to them on LinkedIn. There are other normal people. I actually message previous scholars and ask them about their interview experience. And many of them are also written about their interview experiences on Medium and other blogging websites. So it's essential that you keep looking at people who pages that give you information about these opportunities, and also connect with your seniors and be active in the clubs that are there in your college. I feel, again, you will, they're also another medium to connect with people and network, and that's how you'll come to know about opportunities. And as far as preparing for the interview, specific to the Google scholarship, it's very important, because this scholarship is only for first and second year individuals who identify as female. So in your first and second year, we have very basic subjects that are being taught. So it's very important that you're thorough in them, because they will definitely test that. And it's important that you brush up on your data structures and algorithms. They're just an inevitable part in every interview, at least in our undergraduate level. So yeah, those are my tips.
Great to hear that. And where do you see yourself and your career going with this opportunity?
Actually, during our, so we just had our scholarship retreat get over. And I think a majority part of the sessions, it was focused on developing us as an individual, and also to actually inspire us to come and work at Google. So I definitely see myself working at Google, because it's a dream company that one can work for. And I got to know more about their work culture and their community, and it was so wonderful. But if I see myself working there, but also I'm still in my second year. I'm just like finding and figuring out what path I should take after my engineering. I do have research in my mind. And that's definitely something that I'm looking forward to. So yeah, hopefully everything spans out well.
Absolutely. Good going. And definitely we also like have an anticipation that you'll be reaching the heights which you're aimed at right now.
Thank you so much.
So keep your faith and keep your hard work, and definitely you'll be, you know, reaching the heights.
Yeah. Thank you so much, sir.
Thanks, Bhuvanashree. Thanks a lot.
Om Namah Shivaya. Warm greetings to all our viewers. My name is Sriram Devanathan. I'm currently serving as principal, Amrita School of Engineering, Bengaluru campus. It is indeed a pleasure to offer a few comments to commend the noteworthy achievements of Ms. Bhuvanashree, whose video you have seen, winner of the 2021 Asia Pacific Generation Global Scholarship for Women in Computer Science. It is indeed a remarkable achievement, and I'm sure that the juniors who will be considering a career in computer science, in engineering in general, would be greatly inspired by this achievement. Bhuvanashree is indeed an asset and a matter of pride for Amrita Vishwavidyapeetha. We certainly have a lot of students who have gone to the highest levels of proficiency and competency, not just in India, but across the world, in various domains, in various fields of knowledge and study. Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, under the noble vision and the remarkable guidance of Mata Amritanandamayi, the Chancellor of the university, has always strived for excellence in a holistic way. And this enthusiastic participation in global platforms and selection to the highest levels at a global level, it is indeed reflective of the way Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham has executed on the noble vision of Amma. I warmly congratulate Ms. Bhuvanashree, and I wish her all the very best in all her future endeavors. And my sincere wish that all the youngsters may see the video and get inspired to also apply and rise to great heights. Within Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, the achievements of students like Ms. Bhuvanashree indeed have a lot of backup, support, contributions from the university's leaders who have helped in designing and executing a wonderful curricular design and wonderful program. Along with that, the campus leaders, the management, the faculty members, the non-teaching staff, all their support all comes together in the achievements of students as well. And I especially congratulate the faculty members of the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Amrita School of Engineering, Bengaluru, for their role and contribution in this achievement as well. I am so happy that I had have the privilege of giving this commendation to Ms. Bhuvanashree. And I really hope that we will have many, many more such achievements coming in the near and far future. Thank you all. I wish you all a very safe and healthy one. Om Namah Shivaya.